Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Enderal. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today I'll be reading about Whispertrees, which I found right here at Old Three River Watch. About Whispertrees. Presumably only few travelers or nature lovers won't have noticed the whispers in the wind in the area of Enderal's sun coast. If one pauses for a moment and listens to the chimes of the wind, one will catch the feeling of not being alone in the scenery. Superstitious people believe in a legend that the whispering sound, which sounds so different from the gloomy breath of the whisperwood, and has its roots in its own tale, of the voice of a path-abiding young woman who gave her life at the Sun Coast for the cure of her fellow man. "Grandfather, Grandfather, we are bored. Can't you tell us one of your stories again?" asked the two little children as they came excitedly into the house. The grandfather, who sat in front of the lit fireplace, turned around and gave them a smile. "Gladly. Which story do you want to hear today?" he asked, and pointed beside him. "Sit down beside me." "The story about the whispering in the trees at the Sun Coast," said one of the children, while they settled with their grandfather. "You are talking about the voice of Lariel, aren't you?" He paused for a short moment to gather his thoughts, and then continued, "This is a tale, which is already a few centuries old, which my grandfather told me, like I tell it to you now. Today we live here at the coast unburdened and secure, but it wasn't always like that." He furrowed his brow. "Once a fatal and unknown sickness ruled here. At first it only befell the animals and caused them to slowly perish, as if the emerging famine wasn't already bad enough. Suddenly also the people in the region fell sick. Apothecary came from the surrounding villages to help the people, but even they weren't able to fight off the sickness. Then a young woman named Lariel spoke up, one of the few who wasn't stricken with sickness yet. 'Let me pray to Malphus. I was path-abiding my whole life. Maybe I will be able to bring our Lord to a merciful mood so that he may help us.' Nobody wanted to forbid it, as many had already lost all hope, and so Lariel climbed up a hill in order to pray there alone in a clearing to Malphus. Day and night she kneeled there and prayed without cease. She even refused to eat and drink, but there was no sign from Malphus, and every day more people died. However, the woman stayed true to her faith and continued to pray. After 10 daybreaks and nightfalls, she eventually died of her thirst. Then Malphus had mercy and spoke to the last survivors. 'You were to be judged, since you started to forget your path and became pathless, but the sacrifice and faith of the young Lariel made me show you grace. Let her body lie there and come back tomorrow to this clearing where she prayed to me. There you shall find a small tree and an herb growing on this tree. Give this herb to your sick, and they shall be healthy again, for that you never again forget your path and my mercy.' The next day the people returned to the clearing and really found a young tree in the same place where Lariel had need for praying, but no trace of her body. There they realized that Lariel became the tree. As they got closer to harvest the herb Malphus spoke about, they heard a hushed whisper that seemed to come from the tree and was similar to Lariel's voice. The apothecary were able to turn the herb and other ingredients, which had no effect before, into a potion to successfully heal the sick. Therefore they called the tree Lariel, and the herb which grew on it, Whisperweed. And this is already the end to my tale. And now, off to bed you go. It is quite late,' said the grandfather, as he noticed the sun setting behind the horizon. 'I can tell you another story tomorrow,' he added as he looked into the children's sad faces. 'Hooray!' both shouted at the top of their lungs, and... This is all I could read out of the old and tattered book I found at the loiterer. It seems that it used to be a collection of old legends and tales. If this is the fact, then the validity of this story is to be doubted. However, fact is, there really was a plague at the Sun Coast several hundreds of years ago, which caused many people to die. It is also fact that this plague vanished as suddenly as it appeared. What remains is the question, what happened to the tree? The soft wind-like whispering can be heard today, when one waits long enough and listens, everywhere between the trees of the Sun Coast. It can't be linked to one single tree, and the clearing with the original tree itself, where the young Lariel sacrificed her life, can't be found anymore. Even if there were times where the harvest of the whisper weed filled wagon loads, today it is very hard to find. Just as fleeting and vagrant as the sound of the whispering itself, moving between the trees, it seems that the mysterious herb grows and decays in our times so fast that only selected apothecary and traders are able to harvest it. And the secret to the time and place of the harvest they are keeping under lock and key. But even the indebted aren't able to recreate the healing effect from which was once the gift of Malphysis to the suffering people, no matter what ingredients they use. So you, dear reader, if you're truly interested into the secrets of the herb, you have to search for the whisperweed yourself, even if you, like so many before you, will most likely only be able to get what you want for large amounts of coins from the knowledge of insiders. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Enderal about Whispertrees.